we're at the point where this is the newest, the greatest, the next generation. This is the future of exercise. This is the future of rehabilitation. We need to learn how to use this safely. Now, they've been doing all this research in Japan, and now that it's come to America, there's all these other companies that made these other bands. If you look on Amazon, you can buy tight bands, you can buy rigid bands, you can buy blood pressure pump-up cuffs. I mean, there's so many different products. It's like, you know, all you see are pictures of ripped, tan, shredded, hot people. But that, you know, that's great. But not everyone's a model. Not everyone has that kind of time. I mean, I like food. I like to eat whatever I want to eat. So when I work out so that I can eat whatever I want to eat. And as you get older, KAATSU is something that you can use to help keep you strong, to help keep you lean, to help with your balance, to help with your focus, to help with your concentration. They have studies showing that KAATSU helps improve circulation into your head. The cosmonauts in Russia, they caught on to what Dr. Sato was doing. They said, hey, we need some way to help decrease cerebral edema in our astronauts. When you go to space, the gravity is not pulling the blood to your legs anymore. So that edema starts to stay in your head. And what they found is when you put those bands on your legs, that thin elastic band, it allows you to move and it allows that blood flow to come in and out, but that creates a lower body negative pressure. Just like if you were to lay on your back for a prolonged period of time. If you were on bed rest and you weren't allowed to stand up, if you're laying flat, you have a hard time getting blood flow in and out of your legs. But when you apply KAATSU bands to your legs, it creates that lower body negative pressure. Putting bands on your legs mimics the effects of gravity. So if you have someone that's been bedridden for a long time, you put the bands on their legs and that will mimic them standing up. We're cooking turkeys here. We're cooking long-term. This is a long road. This isn't quick. This is not a quick fix. Yes, you will feel a pump. You'll feel better. But when you take the bands off, that blood flow returns to normal. Your blood pressure starts to stabilize and everything goes right back to where it was. Yes, you have that pump. You have that feel. You feel stronger, but everything starts to return to normal. And as you do KAATSU more frequently, it starts to get easier and easier, and you can increase those pressures and you can challenge yourself a little bit more. Now, if you have a bad heart, if you have a low ejection fraction, or if you have congestive heart failure or something along those lines, you know, of course you never really want to mess with that anyways. But again, that goes back to, are you healthy enough to work out? And when you get older, it gets harder and harder to work out. It gets harder and harder to move. Your cartilage on your joints starts to wear down over time. Things start to get stiff. We sit in chairs. I'm sitting in a chair right now. Things are getting stiff just sitting here. And you wear those joints out. It's like wearing out your brake pads, but you can't change your brake pads. So the movement gets painful. And so you stop moving as much. And those rivers of blood throughout your body slow down. You don't have that circulation. But with KAATSU, you're opening up the dam. You're opening up those rivers slowly. Not a big rip open, but just slow and steady. And that's going to help improve circulation. It'll help improve your breathing. It helps improve your strength. And then what you'll start to notice is that you're more focused. You're more aware. You're more concentrated. KAATSU helps with your sleeping. It helps with your memory. You know, there's all these things. It sounds too good to be true. It's amazing. It's something that you just can't explain until you try it on yourself. Do your research. Do your homework. Look at the different options. Look into FDA approval. Is high intensity exercise FDA approved? No, it's a method. Is CrossFit FDA approved? No, it's a method. KAATSU is a method. KAATSU is not BFR. There was a clinician that labeled KAATSU as BFR and they just ran with it. But there's BFR and then there's KAATSU. They're two different worlds. BFR focuses on taking to a full occlusion and then backing down to a specific occlusion pressure. KAATSU is a slow, gradual process where you have intermittent compression at a light pressure, and then you gradually work up. That's the beauty of KAATSU, because you start low and you work your way up. I wouldn't ask my elderly patients to run a marathon. I'm just going to ask them to get up and walk. You can get that heavy pump. You can get that feeling of lifting heavy weights without lifting any weights at all. All you need is a rubber band and yourself. It's great. You really need to try it. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out with me. I'm always available to ask questions. I love this thing. This is something I've been using for about a year now, and I am absolutely sold. I am. At first, I was like you. I was skeptical. You know, this sounds too good to be true. Where has this been? And it's great. I'm so happy that I found it because it's changed my life. I have more time to play with my kids. I have more time to focus on other things like this. I am able to educate you on something that's going to change your life. Why not give it a shot? Check it out. If you have any questions, check me out. My name is Cory Keirn, and I'd be happy to help. Thanks, guys. Have a good day.